Hey, Gavin.
Oh, Gavin. I'm so sorry. I forgot you were coming. We've just been hit with a possible murder-for-hire case, and we're just going to have to reschedule.
Well, dear, what's the point in confirming our appointments if you're not going to keep them?
I have no control over when people are killed, and this case has a ticking clock on it, so...
You want to see a ticking clock? This is my schedule today, and these are the hours for which you will be billed.
Someone's life is in the balance.
Well, I'm not paid to care about that. I am paid to care about you by the hour.
Hey, Gavin. Chief. We know the information is being leaked to the Baylor family's attorney by somebody in your division, and Gavin needs to interview everyone here.
But I haven't prepared everybody for this, and you haven't told your detectives that Gavin needs to talk to them?
No. Well, now may be a very good time to do it.
All right, everyone, may I have your attention just for a moment, please? I know that everyone's been through the ringer on this whole Shoot Newton case, and, all of you saw my attorney, Gavin, at your depositions. Some of you may know him from his days as a city attorney.
Of course I do. Gavin defended me in my favorite case ever. I was driving my car, and I ran over some dirtbag who was shooting at me, okay? So his parents sued me. Now, at the end of the trial, Gavin turns to the jury, and he said,
well, the lieutenant was being shot at through his windshield. What'd you want him to do? Honk if he loved Jesus?
Yeah. Honk if you love Jesus. I was just gonna say that.
Yes, yes. Good times indeed.
I take it Gavin wants to talk to us.
To make a long story short, Commander, yes.
Has this been cleared with our union reps?
Well, I'm not swearing anyone. And it's completely confidential. And I just have a short list here of 5 questions. See? 1 page.
Gabriel, this won't take long. I'll even go first. Chief, you mind if we use your conference room?
No, not at all.
Thank you.